Hi, so my name's Dave Lammercraft. I'm Plant Life's Lichen and Moss Specialist. And I'm here just to say a massive thank you to all of you who have donated to our Rainforest Appeal. Myself and my colleagues wanted to, you know, say a massive, massive thank you. We've been overwhelmed by the response to it. And I wanted to say thank you, not from my office, but from a bit of rainforest itself. So I'm here in one of my favourite bits of rainforest in northwest Wales at a place called Gansfluid. I'm just going to quickly pause and flip the camera so I can show you why this habitat and some of the species are so special. So here we are, I'll just give you a quick view around the site. It's looking fantastic in this early spring sunshine. So I'm quickly going to show you some of the special species here. On these rocks just here, this lovely sort of golden tinged velvety green moss is one of the rarest mosses in Europe. It's called the prostrate signal moss, Somatophyllum demissum, and the largest population in the UK is here at this site. It's probably one of the largest in Europe, I wouldn't be surprised. There's only half a dozen sites in the UK. It's found also in Southwest Ireland. There's more patches of it here. And a big old patch here. It likes these kind of sloping sides to the boulders. Just gonna quickly nip over here and show you one of my favorite lichens. So this big, big spread of gray running up this beautiful birch tree here. It's one of the coral lichens. It's called the black-eyed Susan lichen, or Bunodophorum melanocarpon to give it its scientific name. You can see why it gets called a coral lichen. It's just a beautiful thing. And then I'll try and show you why it's called black-eyed Susan. Don't know if you can see on the undersides around here, undersides of the lobes, it's got little black dots, and there it's black eyes. I'll try and show you down here. So these black patches are basically where all the spores come from. So that's the black-eyed Susan. So we're going to just nip over here now and I'll show you some of the ferns. So although it's the lichens and mosses that really make these habitats really special and internationally important, they're also very good for ferns. And this here is one of our smallest ferns. They're not looking particularly good because it's been so dry. So they're all sort of dried up and a little bit desiccated, but they'll soon spring back to life as soon as it rains again, which I'm sure it will soon enough. But this dark green here, and all the way up over the top of the boulder, all the way along there. This is all Wilson's filmy fern. So there's two species of filmy fern in Britain, Wilson's and Tunbridge. And you get both in these woods, but this is Wilson's, which tends to be the commoner one really. And it's, you kind of wouldn't necessarily realize it's a fern. It looks a little bit like it could be a moss. It's very small. But it's a beautiful little thing. So there we go. Hope you enjoyed that very quick tour of what makes this place so special. And thank you once again. We really mean it. And you know, your support will help us carry on working on these species and in these sites, not just here in Wales, but also in Scotland and elsewhere in the UK, in southwest England and northwest England. So thank you, it's been fantastic.